learning outcomes. After studying this module, you shall be able to understand the concept of secondary market, learn about stock exchange in India with its function, know various intermediaries in secondary market, process of trading in secondary market, concept of margin money, know the development of secondary market. The capital market, apart from the primary market, also includes the secondary market, where the existing issues are traded. These secondary markets, also referred to as stock markets, deals in stock or equity. The capital market in India consists of two kinds, primary market, number two, secondary market. We shall now discuss the secondary market. When one investor purchases the share from another investor through stock exchange, the transaction is said to take place in secondary market. The secondary market deals with exchange of securities that have been listed through the primary market, where the price of share is predetermined. The price in the secondary market is determined on the basis of demand and supply besides other numbers of factors. Secondary market provides liquidity and tradability to the shares issued by a company to general public. In case no number of shares being issued in the secondary market be greater the number of shares sold through the primary market. Distinction between primary market and secondary market. The main points of distinction between the primary market and secondary market are as follows. Number one, definition. In primary market, an investor purchases share directly from the company, whereas in secondary market, an investor purchases the share from another investor through stock exchange. Number two, the main function of primary market is to raise long-term funds through fresh issue of securities, whereas in the secondary market, they provide continuous and ready market for existing long-term securities. Last, participants. The major players in the primary market are financial institutions, mutual funds, underwriters, and individual investors, while the major players in the secondary markets are all of these and the stockbrokers who are members of the stock exchange. Fourth, determination of prices. In primary market, the prices are determined by the management with due compliance with SEBI requirement for new issue of securities. But in case of secondary market, the price of the security is determined by force of demand and supply of the market. Let us throw some light on the concept of stock exchange. As mentioned above, that stock exchange is the term commonly used for a secondary market, which provides a place where different types of existing securities such as shares, debentures, bonds and government securities can be bought and sold on a regular basis. The securities of companies which raises money from general public and other investors are required to enlist their securities in stock exchanges. Once the securities are listed in the stock exchanges, the buying and selling in those securities among different investors begins. Thus, stock exchange helps in providing liquidity to securities of companies. Stock exchange in India. The first organized stock exchange in India was started in Mumbai, known as Bombay Stock Exchange, commonly known as BSE. It was followed by Ahmedabad Stock Exchange in 1894 and Kolkata Stock Exchange in 1908. The Securities Contract Regulation Act was passed in 1956 for recognition and regulation of stock exchanges in India. At present, we have 21 stock exchanges in the country. Of these, the most prominent stock exchanges are Bombay Stock Exchange, National Stock Exchange, and Multi Commodity Exchange. Most of the trading in the Indian stock market take place on these three stock exchanges, the Bombay Stock Exchange, National Stock Exchange, and MCX. BSE has been in existence since 1975. The NSE, on the other hand, was formed in 1992 and started trading in 1994. However, both exchanges follow the same trading mechanism, trading hours, settlement process, etc. At the last count, more than 5,000 companies are listed on BSE, making it world's top exchange in terms of listed members. The companies listed on BSE Limited command a total market capitalization of $1.24 trillion as of March 2014. It is also one of the world's leading exchanges, third largest in March 2014 for option index trading, source World Federation of Exchange, whereas NSE has a market capitalization of more than $1.5 trillion and number of securities equity segment available for trading are 3,091 as on June 2014. MCX Stock Exchange Limited is an Indian stock exchange. It commenced operation in the currency derivative segment on October 7, 2008 under the regulatory framework of Security and Exchange Board of India, that is SEBI, and Reserve Bank of India, that is RBI. The exchange is recognized by SEBI under Section 4 of the Securities Contract Regulation Act 1956. In line with global best practices and regulatory requirement, clearing and settlement is conducted through a separate clearing corporation known as MCX SXAT Clearing Corporation Limited. MCX SX was granted the status of a recognized stock exchange by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, Government of India on December 21, 2012. It received commencement certificate from market regulator SEBI for trading in new segments such as equity, futures and options on equity, interest rate derivatives and wholesale debt market on December 19, 2012. Another stock exchange that needs special mention is Over the Counter Stock Exchange of India, commonly known as OTCEI. It was also promoted by the financial institution like UTI, ICICI, IDBI, IFCI, LICI, etc. In September 1992, specially to cater to small and medium sized companies with equity capital of more than rupees 30 lakhs and less than rupees 25 crores. It helps entrepreneurs in raising finances for their new projects in a cost effective manner. Now we will proceed on functions of a stock exchange. The function of a stock exchange can be enumerated as follows. Point number one, it provides ready and continuous market. By providing a place where listed securities can be bought and sold regularly and conveniently, a stock exchange ensures a ready and continuous market for various shares, debentures, bonds, and government securities. This lends a higher degree of liquidity to holdings in these securities, as the investor can encash their holding as and when they want. Point number two, it provides information about prices and sales. A stock exchange maintains complete record of all transactions taking place in different securities every day and supplies regular information on their prices and sales volume to press and other media. In fact, nowadays you can get information about minute to minute movement in prices of selected shares on TV channels like CNBC Awaaz, Zee Business, NDTV Profits and ET Now. This enables the investors in taking quick decisions on purchase and sale of securities in which they are interested. Point number three, it provides safety to dealings and investments. Transactions on the stock exchange are conducted only amongst its member with adequate transparency and in strict conformity to its rules and regulations, which include the procedure and timings of delivery and payment to be followed. This provides a higher degree of safety to dealings at the stock exchanges. Securities and Exchange Board of India also regulates the business in stock exchanges in India and the working of the stock brokers. Point number four, it helps in mobilization of savings and capital formation. Efficient functioning of stock market creates a conducive climate for an active and growing primary market. Good performance and outlook for shares in the stock exchanges imparts buoyancy to the new issue market, which helps in mobilizing savings for investment in industrial and commercial establishment. Point number fifth, it is a barometer of economic and business conditions. Stock exchanges reflect the changing condition of economic health of a country. As the share price are highly sensitive to changing economic, social and political conditions. It is observed that during the periods of economic prosperity, the share prices tend to rise. Conversely, prices tend to fall when there is economic stagnation and the business activities slow down as a result of depression. Regulations of stock exchanges. Hence, as early as 1956, the Security Contract Regulation Act was passed, which provided for recognition of stock exchanges given by government, central government particularly. Provisions are made for framing of goods bylaws given by each and every stock exchanges. This is done for regulation and control of their functioning. It is again based on the approval by the government. The Security Contract Regulation Act of 1956 provides inter alia for recognition of stock exchanges and regulation of their functioning, licensing dealers, recognition of contracts, controlling speculation, restricting rights of equitable holders of shares. All stock exchanges are required to submit information relating to its affairs as required by the government from time to time. The government was given wide powers relating to listing of securities, make or amend bylaws, withdraw recognition or supersede the governing bodies of stock exchanges in extraordinary abnormal situations. Under the Act, the government promulgated the Security Contract Rules 1957, which provided inter alia for the procedures to be followed for recognition of the stock exchanges. Submission of periodical returns and annual returns by recognized stock exchange, inquiry into the affairs of recognized stock exchanges and their members and requirement for listing of securities. Now we will shift to intermediaries in secondary market. The secondary market consists of different players, which includes market regulators and facilitators besides buyers and sellers in the market. The important ones are listed below: regulators. The security markets assist in channelization of funds from surplus sector to deficit sector or from unproductive sector to productive sector, which is very vital for the development of economy. Any failure in the system could have adverse effect on the sentiments of the players in the market. It is therefore very necessary to have proper regulatory mechanism which should monitor the market. Securities and Exchange Board of India, it keeps watch over the activities taking place within the security market. Reserve Bank of India, it keeps watch over the activities relating to financing of players in the market through banks. Depositories and custodian. In the past, corporate securities were traded in the physical form. The system was inherited with a number of limitations such as delay in transfer of securities, loss due to theft, etc. Keeping in view these problems, the physical form of securities was considered unsafe and it was decided that the securities shall be traded in dematerialized form. This implies that securities shall not possess physical or material structure in order to facilitate trading of securities in dematerialized form or scriptless trading. A different set of institutions was bought in the financial markets. These are known as depositories. The custodians are the institutions which hold securities on behalf of security holders. Brokers and sub-brokers. An investor intending to purchase or sell his security through stock exchange cannot directly execute his transaction on his own. For this purpose, he has to take help of the registered member of the stock exchange. These registered members are known as brokers. Thus, a broker acts as a legal agent of his clients, that is investors, while transacting shares on his behalf. A stock broker is expected to maintain high standard of fairness and integrity while conducting business for his client. Foreign institutional investors. These are the investors from countries outside India. They are required to be registered with SEBI and RBI before dealing in securities markets. A registered FII is required to buy or sell securities on the stock exchange only for delivery. FII cannot invest in shares for jobbing purpose, that is immediate buy and sell. Portfolio managers. According to SEBI guidelines, portfolio manager means any person who, pursuant to a contract or arrangement with a client, advises or directs or undertakes on behalf of the client, whether as a discretionary portfolio manager or otherwise, the management or administration of a portfolio of securities or the funds of the client, as the case may be. Merchant banker. Merchant banker are the financial intermediaries which assist corporate identities in raising funds from different sources. It could be in the form of equity shares or loan from financial institutions. Merchant bankers are required to be registered with SEBI under Security and Exchange Board of India, Merchant Banker Regulation 1992. Underwriters. According to Companies Act 1956, if any issue of equity share of company is not subscribed up to 90% of the total issue size, the allotment of shares in such a case is considered irregular allotment. Therefore, a company when comes out with public issue and have apprehension that perhaps its issue may not be subscribed to the extent of 90%, enter into an agreement with certain merchant bankers who acts as underwriters for the company. Securities Appellate Tribunal. This is a forum where an investor, listed company or any participant of the security market can approach for remedial action issued against an order issued by SEBI. The Securities Appellate Tribunal provides an opportunity of being heard to both the parties and issues order which is binding on SEBI as well as other parties. Process of trading in secondary market. The process of trading in securities can be explained with the help of an example. Placement of order and execution of transaction. Investor A wants to sell 1000 shares of ONGC Limited and investor B wants to purchase the same shares. Both the investors would first contract their respective broker. Let X be the broker of A and Y be the broker of B. A would place his order, sell order through X, and B would place his buy order through Y. The transaction would take place only if the prices of the two investors would match. Now, broker X and Y will have to issue contract notes to their respective client A and B respectively. The contract note is an evidence of the fact that the broker has executed a transaction in a given security for his client. Payment and delivery. The seller client A, after receiving the contract note, will have to transfer shares in the broker account, and the buyer client B, after receiving the contract note from his broker, will have to deposit money in the broker's account for the shares purchased by him. Settlement of transaction in stock exchange. The stock exchange has the responsibility of settling the transaction among its brokers. Therefore, for each trading day, there is pay in and pay out of securities and funds. The broker X and Y, after having received funds and shares for their respective clients, would transfer them in their account. Margin money. Margin money is a fund deposited by a broker in the exchange depending upon the amount of transactions conducted or proposed to be conducted by them in the securities. Such exchanges stipulate following kind of margin to cover risk relating to price fluctuation in share prices. Types of margin money. Gross exposure margin. The margin linked to the total amount of transaction conducted by the broker on the exchange. For example, a broker sold 100 shares of Wipro Limited for rupees 80,000 for one client and purchased 100 shares of TCS Limited for rupees 90,000 for his other client. The net liability of the broker towards exchange will be rupees plus 80,000 minus 90,000, that is rupees 10,000. Since he will be getting rupees 80,000 from the exchange for selling shares and would be paying rupees 90,000 to exchange for the shares bought by him, though the liability is rupees 10,000 on net basis, but it is rupees 1,70,000 on gross basis. Net exposure margin. Net exposure margin is charged at the rate of 10% on the excess purchase over sale by a broker or vice versa. Mark to market margin. The share price are subject to frequent change. Therefore, the price at which the transaction has been conducted in the exchange may not be equal to the closing price of the shares at the end of the day. Development in the secondary market. SEBI and stock exchanges have provided number of provisions to regulate and protect investors, the interest of investors in secondary market regulations. Rolling settlement. Earlier, trading in the stock exchanges was done without the use of computers and the advanced computer software as it is today. Today, with the electronic computer-based system of recording and carrying out of shares transactions, stock exchanges go in for rolling settlement. That means transactions are settled after a fixed number of days of the transaction rather than on a particular day of the week. For example, if a stock exchange goes in 40 plus 2 days of rolling settlement, the transaction is settled within 2 working days of occurring of the transaction, T being the day of the transaction. In T plus 7 days of rolling settlement, the transaction is settled on the 7th day after the transaction. This is facilitated through electronic transfer of shares through dematerialization account or DMAT account. That is, the shares does not have a physical form of a paper document but a computerized record of a person holding a share. And though transfer of money electronically or through checks payment is settled. Circuit breaker. To curb excessive volatility, SEBI has prescribed a system of circuit breaker. The circuit breaker bring about a nationwide coordinated halt in trading on all equity and equity derivative markets. An index-based market-wide circuit breaker system applies at 3 stages of the index movement, either way at 10%, 15% and 20%. The breakers are triggered by movement of either S&P, CNX, Nifty or Sensex, whichever is breached earlier. Imposition of circuit filter. SEBI has introduced circuit filter for shares being traded in stock exchanges and also for the stock index. According to this, a share cannot move beyond plus and minus 5% of its previous day closing price. For example, a share closed at a price of rupees 100, then next day it cannot trade beyond the price range of 95 to 105. We shall now recapture what we have learned so far. Secondary market. When one investor purchases the shares from another investor through stock exchange, the transaction is said to take place in secondary market. Stock exchange is the term commonly used for secondary market, which provides a place where different types of existing securities such as shares, debentures, bonds and government securities can be bought and sold on a regular basis. Function of a stock exchange: it provides easy and continuous market. It provides information about prices and sales. It provides safety to dealing and investment. It helps in mobilization of saving and capital formation. It is a barometer of economic and business condition. Regulation of stock exchange: the Security Contract Regulation Act 1956 provides inter alia for recognition of stock exchange and regulation of their functioning, licensing dealer, recognition of contracts, controlling speculations, restricting rights of equitable holders of shares. Intermediaries in secondary market: the secondary market consists of different players, which includes market regulators and facilitates besides buyer and sellers in the market. The important ones are listed below: regulator, Security and Exchange Board of India, Reserve Bank of India, depositories and custodian, broker and sub-broker, foreign institutional investors, portfolio managers, merchant bankers, underwriters, securities appellate tribunals. Process of trading in secondary market. The procedure of trading in securities can be explained with the help of an example: placement of order and execution of transaction, payment and delivery, settlement of transaction in stock exchange. Margin money. Margin money is a fund deposited by a broker in the exchange depending upon the amount of transaction conducted or proposed to be conducted by them in the securities. Stock exchange stipulate following kinds of margin to cover risk relating to price fluctuation in share price. Development in the secondary market. SEBI and stock exchanges have provided number of provisions to regulate and protect interest of investors in secondary market regulations. Rolling settlement, circuit breaker, imposition of circuit filter. Thank you.